Hurricane Ian hit western Cuba this morning as a Category 3 storm and continues to track toward the west coast of Florida.
Morgan's been tracking the storm. She joins us with the latest. Morgan.
Hi, good morning, you guys. That, again, still a Category 3 storm with maximum sustained wind speeds at 125 miles per hour. Now moving off of Cuba into the Atlantic, where it'll gain some momentum and move into that Category 4 territory. That happens late tonight, early tomorrow morning. Approaches then the Tampa area, so that Gulf Coast of Florida, by late Wednesday night into Thursday morning. We'll watch for that landfall to occur as a Category 3 storm, so that 111-plus mile-per-hour territory. This bringing it right over Tampa, certainly a worst-case scenario for this area, but we could see this wiggle really anywhere south from Tampa down to Fort Myers. And if that wiggles a little further south and eastward, we look at an even bigger area that sees that damage and feels that damage. Hurricane warnings, obviously, they're lighting up the Gulf Coast. Wednesday morning into Thursday morning is where you start to feel the hurricane force wind speeds, plus anywhere from 10 to 20 inches of rainfall for these areas. When you talk hurricanes, winds are a big deal, but it's the water and the surge that are an even bigger deal and often lead to that life-threatening issue. So life-threatening surge with that storm surge warning in place, 5 to 10 foot waves, starting to feel those impacts early Wednesday morning as well. That's very latest. Back to you.